Welcome to Narc Abuse No More, where we're here to help educate you about narcissistic abuse, because your feelings do matter. Hi, and welcome to another podcast of Narc Abuse No More with your host, Dr. and Evangelist, K.L. Rich. Thanks for tuning in today. Today is Wednesday, August the 2nd of 2023. I pray that you have had a blessed, stress-free, narcissistic-free, abuse-free week so far, and that the remainder of this week will continue to be blessed for you as well. But if you have been going through narcissistic abuse, we're here to help you today. My name is Dr. K.L. Rich with Narc Abuse No More, where we're here to help you admit what you feel in order to heal from the effects of narcissistic abuse, because your feelings do matter. Yes, they do. But before we go on with today's podcast, I'd like to invite you to visit us on our website at www.narcabusenomore.org. Again, that website address is www.narcabusenomore.org. NARCAbusenomore.org. And on our website, you'll find valuable information regarding narcissism, relationships, and if you have missed any of these podcasts, all you have to do is go directly to our website and listen to us from there. Now, we are on every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 9 a.m. Central, and that is on SoundCloud, iHeartRadio, Spotify, Spreaker, Google Play, iTunes, CastBox, and Deezer. We're also on Amazon Audible, Rumble, Brighteon, and the YouTube. That's why we're on YouTube. So you have a variety of different platforms that you can listen to us from. But if all else fails, all you have to do is go directly to our website at www.narcabusenomore.org. All right, what are we talking about today? We are talking about signs that you have a jealous mother, signs your mother has jealous issues. She is jealous of you. Today's topic is coming from bustle.com, and we often deal with narcissism when it comes to so many different issues relating to abuse, toxic behaviors. But one of the toxic behaviors that is that thrives inside of a narcissist is jealousy. And you can expect like outside people to be jealous of you, envious of you for whatever reason. You expect these things out of others. But when it comes to your mother, that is a whole different ball game. Now, mother-daughter relationships are oftentimes complicated. You have some that have great relationships with between the mother and daughter, and then you have those that are not so great. And when you're dealing with a narcissistic mother who is self-centered, who is absent emotionally, who is very cold, unempathetic, and it can cause problems, especially when these mothers are jealous of their daughters. You might say that is strange. It is not normal for a mother to be jealous of her very own daughter, but it does happen, and many mothers are jealous of their daughters. And it's so sad, because a mother should be cheerful, happy that her daughter's accomplishing things, and these are ugly traits to have. They allow the jealousy to linger, and instead of improving their own life and doing what it is that they need to do to have their own happiness in their own life, they allow that time to be plagued with jealousy of their own child, the very child that they gave birth to. Again, many people may find it strange that a mother would be jealous of her child, but there are many mothers who are jealous of their own children. And so therefore, you have to understand that this is a flaw. If you have a mother that's like this, this is a flaw that is in your mother. You may have a she may have just these type of feelings, and so these are flaws. No one should be jealous of their children. One thing when it comes to parenting, a parent should be happy when their children is doing well, successful, happy, have meaningful relationships. But when you are dealing with this type of jealousy from your mother, it is hard to even stay connected to someone that you know is jealous of you. And so if you suspect your mother is jealous of you, we're going to go over 11 signs that your mother is jealous of you. This is not something that you really want to even talk about or even have to deal with, but it happens where the mother is jealous of their own child, and this can cause a lot of tension in the relationship when you are dealing with a jealous mother. So number one, one of the signs that you are dealing with a jealous mother is your mother always tries to steal the spotlight. Your mother is, when she tries to steal the spotlight or she tries to copy you, she tries to one-up you, that's a sign of jealousy. You may be taking on a new project and she's going to try to do it too. You may have updated your wardrobe and she's going to try to do it too. Whatever it is in life, she will try to one-up you or make you feel as if your achievement isn't anything because hers is better. After all, she's been through this and that, and yours is insignificant in her eyes. So jealous issues will have a hard time trying to stay on level ground when it comes to that jealous mother. Again, this is not something that is your fault. This is a flaw in your own mother due to her own insecurities. At the end of the day, when you're dealing with jealousy, you're dealing with someone who is insecure. Number two, she acts bored when you share big things with her. Jealousy is an emotion that is such an ugly type of emotion. So when you tell her, you might have told her you accomplished something, and she acts as if she's disinterested. She acts as if it's bored. When you share things about your life, she will try to protect herself by not acting as if she's interested in whatever you're doing, or she will cut the phone call short if you're over the phone. She will make the subject short. She will leave you wondering as if she even cares. And the thing is, when you have someone that does that, again, that's a sign that they're jealous. They will take the joy out of whatever you've accomplished because of their own jealousy, because of their insecurities. Number three, another sign that your mother is jealous of you is she will talk behind your back. She will talk behind your back because she's threatened of your success. She's threatened of your beauty. She's threatened of your popularity. She's threatened of your likability. She's threatened of your achievements, your dreams, your goals, your ambitions, especially when she sees them coming to fruition. So therefore, she will pick, she will say things like, things that aren't great about you. She would try to find a flaw in you. She would try to tell others flaws in you. She would try to pick out things that she know maybe are even soft spots or tender spots in you. She would do these things to try to knock you down a peg, and therefore it's a way for her to try excuse me, to try to control you in the sense of it really being about her jealousy. She's very competitive with you. She, instead of acting like a proud mother, a proud parent, she will be the one, the very one that will stab you in the back. And let me just say this, it is so difficult when you're dealing with a jealous mother. Your mother should be that your biggest cheerleader. Your mother should be there as a rock of support. Your mother should be that person that you can go to when you have no one else to go to. But sadly, there are a lot of mothers that have some issues, and one of them being jealousy. They're jealous of their daughters. They're jealous of their children, and it is very sad. And when you recognize this in your mother, then you can understand that you're not going to get that support, and you have to tell yourself that I'm not going to get the support from the one that I really would have wanted it from, because your mother is too busy competing with you rather than being there to congratulate you. So wherever she sees that she may not have done in life, instead of her being happy that you have achieved those things, and let me just say this, people, be careful when you're dealing with a two-forked snake. Jealous people are often like snakes. They have two forked tongues, okay? Have you seen the snake with the two forked tongue, okay? Two directions, I'm gonna say east and west. They will say one thing out of one side of their mouth where they're congratulating you and wishing you well, but then on the other side, they're green with envy. The Bible talks about a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. When you have a mother that is jealous of you, one minute she may be singing your praises, and oftentimes that's if she can get some attention from that. And then the next minute, she's chewing you out, tearing you down, dismissing you, devaluing you, belittling you, acting as if what you've achieved doesn't mean anything. And it's so sad because, you know, oftentimes, and I've said this before, is that people, they are often jealous of the end result, but they're not jealous of the process. Let me repeat that. They're jealous of the end result, but they're not jealous of the process. Let me use myself for an example. You know, I have my doctorate, as you all know, and it took years of work to get to where I was able to accomplish that degree. However, you will have those that are jealous because they may not have done anything, or they may not have put forth an effort, or they didn't even think to do anything of that nature. And so therefore, they're jealous of the outcome, but they didn't see all the hard work you put in, all the papers you had to write, all the tears you had to shed, all the grades that you were worried, am I going to get a B, or if I'm gonna get an A, if I get a high enough grade to stay in this program. Well, they didn't see the process. Come on now. They didn't see the process. So therefore, you have some mothers that they may even know what you went through, but they're jealous of their daughters, and they're jealous of the end result, but they're not jealous of the process. So whereas they could have put the work in themselves, but the thing is that it's sad when a mother has seen her child try to achieve things in life, and the mother is the one that is putting the knife, the dagger, in her daughter's back. And the Bible, Jesus said, he in Matthew chapter 24, he said that your very enemies will be that of one's own family. One's own family. And for many people, your enemy is your mother. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be back in just a moment.
Thank you.
To take your place, backstabbers. And that's oftentimes these, when you're dealing with jealous mothers, they want to take their daughter's place, backstabbers. Number four, your mother has changed her appearance. Your mother begins changing her makeup, her fashion. It's a sign of, it may be a sign of her insecurity because she's jealous of you. She's trying to keep up with you. She don't want her age to be reflected, and so therefore she's trying to emulate you. She might want to borrow your clothes. She might invite herself to your hangout. She wants to intertwine herself with your friends, and therefore this is a sign that your mother is insecure and she may be jealous. Now the thing is, as we get older, we should not want to hang with a younger crowd like we did when we were younger. And so for some daughters, that might be kind of weird for them that their mother wants to be around their age group. Normally there's, for most mothers and daughters, there's at least a 20-year difference for most, unless you had a child very young. For most, it's at least a 20-year difference, and that's a huge difference. And so as a daughter, you want your own friends, your own life, you have your own goals, your ambitions. And this is not to say that you might not take a class with your mom, maybe a art class or just a dance class or something for fun. However, most daughters expect their mothers to have their set of friends around their age group, and then you have yours around your age group, or things that you enjoy doing, that you you have your own separate life apart from your parent. However, when you're dealing with a mother that is jealous, she will try to emulate you in other things such as appearance. I see so many older women that are trying to reverse the signs of aging by even the way that they dress. And you know, a lot of times things are too, as a Christian, for those of us who are Christians, we know there's certain things that is inappropriate for a Christian, especially if you are of mature age. So this is a sign, one of the signs of jealousy in a mother. Number five, she's been known to overreact. There are many situations that can cause someone to react a certain way, such as stress, anxiety, depression, worry, and all those kind of things. However, some of this, when you're dealing with a jealous mother, is a symptom of being jealous. She may be angry. She may give you the silent treatment. She may resort to personal attacks. She may be sarcastic. These are impulsive reactions, and so therefore when she is jealous of you, is as a two-year-old that is acting out, throwing a temper tantrum. She may snap at you for no reason. She may pick an argument. She may go without talking to you. You call, she doesn't pick up the phone, or whatever the case may be. So therefore, these are things that you need to be aware of, so that if you know that this is the type of behavior that your mother is experiencing, that it doesn't get you down and out because of the way that she's acting. Again, you have to tell yourself that this is not about you. This is about her own insecurity. She's trying to make it about you, but it's actually deep down her own insecurities. Number six, she's weird about your relationship with your dad. She's weird about your relationship with your dad, and this could be your father or other people. When you have a jealous mother, she's jealous of the dynamics of your relationships, whether it's your dad. You might be closer to your father than you are to your mother, and so that jealous mother will not like the relationship. She'll envy the relationship that you have with your father. She's upset when you spend time with your father. If you two make an inside joke, she gets offended by it. Basically, she doesn't want anything that's going to leave her out, even if she chooses not to be a part of whatever it is that you all are doing. And so, again, this is self-esteem issues with your mother. It has nothing to do with you. It is okay for you to have a good relationship with your father. It's okay for you to have a good relationship with other people. Sometimes that relationship is going to be much, much better than the relationship that you have with your mother, especially when she's dealing with jealousy issues. When you have someone that's jealous of you, it is difficult to be able to maintain a relationship with that person, because that person, you know that that person has some deep down jealousy, resentment when it comes to you. Whatever it is that they may have wanted to achieve or didn't have the motivation to achieve, whatever the case may be, that's their issue. It has nothing to do with you. And what I mean by that, you can't take it personal. Don't take it personal because your mother is jealous of the relationships that you have with your father or with other people. Number seven, she isn't proud of your success. And let me remind you about the two-forked tongue, okay? So your mother, she can't handle when you have success. She wishes that she had the same. And let me just say this, be careful, because with these type of mothers, you will also get whiplash. What I mean by that, you know, when you're in a car, an accident, whatever, and you get jerked back to reality, kind of, in a sense. The thing is that your mother, she is the type of person, if she is two-forked tongue, she will tell you congratulations and la 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 la, wish you well, I'm proud of you, but at the same time, she's jealous of you and she's envious of you. So she's jealous of your success, she's jealous of your confidence, she's jealous of your popularity, she's jealous that you have the likability factor, she's jealous that you're successful in life, if you get a home or a car or whatever, she's jealous of all these things. Again, it is sad that some mothers are jealous like this. This is not all mothers, but it's sad when you have a mother that may be jealous of their own child. As a parent, you should want your children to succeed. You have those mothers that are so jealous that anything that happens to you, or they will try to take the credit away. Oh, it couldn't have possibly been you that worked hard to succeed. It's always someone else. Let me just say this too, because sometimes you have mothers that will uplift everyone else except for you. You will have, for example, you might have two people that's cardiologists, for example, okay, that works on the heart. The mother can have her daughter could be a cardiologist, and another person is a cardiologist that's not her child. The mother will take the word of the other cardiologist over her own daughter, who is a cardiologist, who's done the work, who's been to medical school, who's put in the hours, who's got her residency, who did all the work. But because she's jealous of her daughter, she will prioritize the other person who has no relation to her at all. She don't even know what school she went to, for that matter. But she will prioritize the other cardiologist, even though she has one in her family, her own daughter. She will belittle her daughter's accomplishments just because of her own insecurities, just because of her own jealousy. And let me just say, that's difficult. You know, that it's really difficult when you know that you have a parent that does not support you in that sense, that's not proud of your success. And let me just say this, because even though they may say it, even though they may say, oh, I'm proud of her, or I'm proud of him, or I'm proud, they will downplay your success. They will cause you to give up on your dreams, give up on your goals. And it's so important for you not to internalize this if you have a jealous mother. Because when you have a jealous mother, you can achieve everything. You can achieve all your dreams, your goals, your ambitions, everything. But when you have that jealous mother that does not support you, that does not embrace you, that jealous mother that is competing with you, that jealous mother that's trying to put you down, you can get all the praises in the world from everyone else, but then if you allow that to internalize that you're not getting it from your mother, all the achievements that you have accomplished, it will mean nothing, and you will be in a depressed state. You will suffer from low self-esteem. You will deal with a lot of internal emotional issues because of allowing the mother's jealousy to overshadow you. You have to talk to yourself. You have to get people around you that support you. When you have a jealous mother, she will make you feel as if nothing you ever do is good enough. She will make you feel as if all your achievements don't matter because someone else is always better than you. Oh, she will tell others, oh, my daughter did this and my daughter did that. But deep down behind closed doors, she is putting you down. She is backstabbing you. Your very mother is the one, when you have a jealous mother, you know, you expect it out of other people. But when it comes from your own mother, when it comes from your own mother, that is something that's very difficult for a lot of daughters. And your validation, when that happens, your validation can't come from your mother. Your validation has to first come from God. In Psalms 139:14, I am fearfully and I am wonderfully made, and I know that full well. You have to tell that to yourself, because some daughters, you're not going to get the validation from your mother. And if you have a two-forked tongue mother, one minute she's singing your praises, the next minute she's bashing you and diminishing your accomplishments and undermining you and competing with you, at least trying to it on some level, it will give you whiplash where your self-esteem will diminish. And you will be wondering what's wrong with you. I'm here today to tell you there's nothing wrong with you. It's your mother. There's nothing wrong with you. When you're dealing with a jealous mother, There's nothing wrong with you. It's your mother. We're going to take a quick break and we'll be back in just a moment.
Every night she walks right in my dreams since I met her from the start. I'm so proud I am the only one who is special in her heart. The girl is mine. The doggone girl is mine. I know she's mine. Yeah, the doggone girl is mine. I don't understand the way you think, saying that she's yours, not mine. Sending roses and your silly dreams, really just a waste of time, because she's mine.
About jealous mother, signs that you have a jealous mother. Number 8, your mom always finds a way to criticize you. You deal with constant criticism, bullying. Again, that's a way that your mother is showing her own insecurities. She criticizes your career choices. She criticizes your friendships. She criticizes things that you may decide that is best for you in your life. She may even do this in front of family and friends. So therefore, she, this is a sign that she is jealous. And this is based off of a New York therapist. And it is so important that when you are confident in who you are, you don't have to be constantly critical of someone else. If you're always finding something to attack other people on, with this person and that person and everything, it's showing that you don't have enough to do in your own life. So when you're dealing with someone that when you're putting up with this type of behavior, you may feel that the relationship is bringing you down. And what do you do when you are dealing with a jealous mother? Sometimes you have to put some distance in between you and that relationship. You have to set boundaries, of course, and also make sure that you be around people who support you, who build you up, people that may be more of a mother figure than the one that you have. All the time, family is not blood. And so therefore, if you have someone that's a good role model to you, they may not be able to be your mother by birth, of course, but the thing is that sometimes your own blood, such as jealous mothers, be the one to tear you down. And so when you can't get that support, that validation, that emotional support that you normally would think you would get from your mother, then it's best to, first of all, get it from God. Allow him to help you to know who you are in him, and then be around other people who will support you. Number 9, she never asks about your life. And this is also double-sided. She never asks about your life. So she never asks about anything that's going on in your life is because she's either busy or just self-absorbed. So she doesn't want to hear about the things that are taking place in your life. And she acts as if she's not interested. Or it can be the opposing side too, where she will ask about things in your life only to be jealous of it later. So this is twofold. You may have the mother that's jealous and she never asks anything about your life, and therefore it's because of her own jealousy and insecurity issues. Or she could ask about what's going on, but it's not because she's concerned. It's because she's jealous. Because anytime you tell someone what you're doing in your life and the dreams and goals you have, and then they start talking about it, they start backstabbing you about it, they start wondering how you were able to do whatever it was that you've done, it is because they're jealous. So it's twofold with that. One can be the jealousy side, whereas they're never interested in anything with you, or it could be the opposite, where they will ask just because they're trying to figure out how you're accomplishing whatever it is that you are doing, or they want to find a way to criticize whatever you are doing. Either way, you have a dagger in your back. Number 10, she constantly tells you you're wrong. She constantly tells you you're wrong. When you are dealing with a jealous mother, you're never right about anything. She always feels like she has to correct you. She has to tell you how to properly do things. It's because of her own jealousy. She has her own stuff, self-esteem issues. So therefore, she has to try to put a cloud over anything that you're doing. And the thing is, you waste time even trying to defend anything when you're dealing with a jealous mother. It's just hard to do, because they are, again, you're dealing with their own insecurities. They don't look at it as insecurity issue, but that's exactly what you have when you have to constantly tell someone else, point out what you feel is their flaws, their wrongs, or whatever the case may be, without looking at your own. Last but not least, she picks fights in your family. A jealous mother is threatened by your relationship with, like I mentioned earlier, your father or other family members or friends. So she tries to pick fights to break things up, to make herself be more relevant, make herself feel more important. And so these relationships can cause, when she's doing this, again, this is a sign of her own insecurity. She feels as if she needs to break things up because, after all, if it's not about her, as we know narcissists are like this, if it's not about her, then she doesn't want any other people in the family or your friends to be able to get along with you. They will even overreact in order to get attention. So if the spotlight is not on them, then they will get upset and they will start an argument out of anything. If this sounds familiar, then your mom may be jealous. But one thing, again, to remember, this is not something that you should take on personally. You can't do anything about someone else's jealousy. These feelings are all within them. You're not wrong. You haven't done anything wrong. It's their insecurity. And there is nothing that you can do to change that within them. However, you can create stronger boundaries in order to keep her from bringing you down. It's sad that, you know, again, when we talk about mothers should always be there for their children. They should be supportive. They should be, you know, your mother should be your cheerleader. Now, this one thing, if you're doing something really wrong, maybe into drugs and all that kind of stuff, but we're not talking about that. We're talking about just mothers that are jealous just because of their daughter's achievements, their daughter's accomplishments, their daughter's dreams, goals, and ambitions that they're pursuing. And the mother, in her own warped sense, is envious and jealous of her own child instead of being there to support. The mother is dealing with her own insecurity issues. So therefore, what she does is she judges her daughter. She competes with her daughter. She puts her daughter down. She backstabs her daughter. She complains about the relationships that her daughter has with other people. All these things are signs that the mother is jealous of her daughter. But I'm going to say this to you today, for those who may be dealing with this. Can you change that in your mother? No. The only thing you can change is how it affects you. That means that you have to allow her to have her own issues. There's nothing you can do about those issues. Nothing at all. However, you can change the dynamics of it affecting you. And that's all that you can do. Not allow it to cause you to have a low sense of self-worth. Your mother's issues don't have to become your issues. They're hers and hers alone. And there's nothing you've done wrong. When you've achieved your dreams, your goals, your ambitions, and your mother fails to support you or is jealous of you or hating on you, then guess what? That speaks more into her issues than it does yours. All right. We are up out of here. I pray that today's podcast has been a blessing to you and that you would know your feelings do matter. This is Dr. K.O. Rich with Narc Abuse No More, helping you to admit what you feel in order to heal from the effects of narcissistic abuse. Until next time. Thank you.